Hello friends, I'm Sudhir and you are enjoying the YouTube channel English Carnival, a journey of learning with joy. Friends, today we are going to explore Sam Horn's well-known prose called How to Avoid an Argument. But friends, before we proceed, I request you to subscribe the channel by just pressing the subscribe button and hitting the bell icon so that you may get the notifications of uploaded such academic videos on this channel called English Carnival in coming days. Friends, before we proceed, let us see some basic objectives of this today's video. Number one, we have to explore and understand the brief contribution of Sam Horn. Number two, we have to explore and understand different techniques, including Tung Fu technique of avoiding the arguments discussed in the essay or prose by Sam Horn. Number three, we have to understand the crux of the essay or prose with the help of certain examples discussed in the essay. Number four, we have to understand the disadvantages of arguments explained by Sam Horn in this essay. And the last one, we have to comment on the overall essay, How to Avoid an Argument. So friends, let us begin with the details of Sam Horn in brief. Friends, Sam Horn's full name is Samuel Lee Horn, and she was born in 1963 in the United States of America. Friends, Sam Horn is an American writer and the founder and chief executive officer of the Intrigue Agency, which has the mission to help people in creating quality communication. Friends, Sam Horn has got recognition as an acclaimed author and communication strategist. Friends, the most important thing is she has invented various revolutionary methodologies in the field of communication. She is associated with the TLC as a member. Here, friends, TLC means Transformation Leadership Council, and she is one of the members of this council. Friends, she has been a top rated speaker along with Seth Godin, then we have Jim Collins, then Tom Peters and Tim Ferriss. Friends, she has had the privilege of speaking to more than 500,000 people across the globe and for hundreds of organizations, including reputed organizations including NASA, National Geographic, Accenture, Cisco, Intel, Capital One, then Asian Leadership and so on. Friends, it is quite appreciable that she wrote some quite renowned and popular books like Washington Post, then Got Your Attention, What's Holding Your Back, 30 Days to Having the Courage and Confidence to Do What You Want, Meet Whom You Want and Go Where You Want. Then we have Someday Is Not a Day in the Week, then Pop, Stand Out in Any Crowd, then Ideapreneur, then Concentrate, then Take the Bully by the Horns, then Tung Fu, and there are so many other titles to her credits as well. Friends, here it shows the significance of her literature, significance of her book, as out of all these titles, there are 6 titles which have been awarded and translated into 17 different languages of the globe, like Chinese, German, Spanish, French, Hindi, Greek, Korean, Polish and Japanese and so on. Friends, in fact, there are some most crucial and colorful threads which every individual is supposed to follow in his or her life, and those are: number one, we have life is the game of action and not reaction. Friends, here we should always have a typical, you know, perception of looking positively towards everything which comes towards us in our lives. Then we have number two, be sincere to yourself. It means, friends, we need to be sincere towards ourselves, our ambitions, family, responsibilities, friends, near and dear ones as well. No matter, or it doesn't matter what other people are doing with us, we should always try to do the best one. And the next one, then we have third one, believe in yourself. It means actually, friends, having faith in ourselves and our actions is very important part of our life. And therefore, we need to remember the line stated by Swami Vivekananda, where he says, start believing in yourself and the world will be at your feet. Therefore, friends, we should never lose our confidence and sense of believing in ourselves. The next fourth number we have, don't force or beg for anything before anybody. It means, friends, it is a life, and here we may suffer, we may be criticized unnecessarily, there may be some people who backbite you, people may leave you without any reason, you may not find the people in the society as per your expectation, and besides all these, there could be many more such issues may occur in your life. So in such circumstances, in such typical plights, we just need to be sincere, confident and polite towards everything and should try always to maintain our self-respect. The next one we have, don't miss a day without laugh or laughing. Friends, we should try to make laughing an obligatory part of our lifestyle, because laughing is a natural therapy of fitness and peaceful life. And the last and the most important one, sixth one we have, avoid unnecessary argument. Friends, this is what we are going to explore today with the help of Sam Horn's popular essay, How to Avoid an Argument. Friends, the title of this prose itself, or the title that we have, How to Avoid an Argument, itself shows that, or what might be there in the essay or prose, and what exactly Sam Horn might be trying to say with the help of this prose or essay called How to Avoid an Argument. So friends, this essay is all about different tips of avoiding unnecessary arguments, and she talks about certain techniques like tung fu techniques with which we can overcome such situations of arguments or arguments like situations. Friends, here Sam Horn gives us certain examples, and with the help of those examples, she tries her best to convince us to be away from such arguments like situations in our day-to-day lives. Friends, here overall speaking, it is quite interesting and informative piece of literature, no doubt, written by Sam Horn. And now let us move towards the prose and see what exactly Sam Horn is trying to say with the help of this prose called How to Avoid an Argument. So let us move. Friends, in fact, there are different situations in the essay about which the author called Sam Horn talks about. But the essay begins with where, on the occasion of the birthday of author's 5-year son named Andrew, it means Sam Horn's 5-year son named Andrew, she and her son Andrew go to the local ice cream parlor, and she just wanted to give a treat of dessert to the friends in the evening. When they approach the ice cream parlor, she finds that the counter of the parlor is with full of customer and full of crowd. Everyone was trying to place his or her orders, but on the other hand, there was only one high school girl behind the counter who was trying to attend every customer in her own way and getting irritated for being helpless before such crowd. When the author's number comes, she asks that high school girl for 3 liters chocolate chip ice cream, but that girl gets angry and immediately says, "Do you know how much, how hard to scoop 3 liters ice cream?" Actually, friends, it is not the expected reply of any kind of shopkeeper or seller or vendor, but due to her helplessness and irritation, that girl replies in such a negative and aggressive way to the author. In fact, friends, the author also gets shocked, but she does not reply to that girl in negative way or in negative manner. In fact, she could have replied her in other aggressive ways, and it might have started the arguments, but she does not do so. Instead of paving the way to any such unwanted statement, she tries to talk from her side and appreciates her efforts and the way she was dealing and handling alone with such huge crowd of customers. And because of this stance taken by the author, the hostility of that high school girl completely melts down, and she serves the author properly and gives big smile with a friendly wave while leaving the counter. Here, friends, we also come across with such situation in our lives, and we need to think that the way we behave in such situation. Friends, here the author says that it is not possible to have the same kind of people as we expect or wish to have in our lives. There are multiple kinds of personalities, and there are different behaviors of people in the society and family as well. But friends, we have to understand this point and explore the thread of understanding to live our life peacefully. Friends, here as the author talks about different tips to be away from dealing with such people or such situation which may create arguments in the essay. She says that we can use these techniques and idea with people and while behaving or dealing with people, and we can avoid arguments. Here, friends, she calls such techniques as Tung Fu technique, in which at first she talks about we have the people handle hassles with humor. Here, friends, hassles means difficult, tough or complicated situation. Actually, we come across so many such difficult situations in our lives where we wish to argue or quarrel with people, and we do not understand how to deal with such situation or such typical plight. In this situation, friends, the writer tells us to behave in a humorous, sporty or funny way. And to prove the same, she gives us two different examples. The first example is of a tall young man, and second example is of the office of the Internal Revenue Service in United States of America. So let us see the first example of a tall young man. Here, friends, what happens once the author finds a tall young man at San Francisco International Airport? People were pointing at him and laughing at him. The author gets surprised by why people are laughing at him and behaving like this. But immediately she realizes that there were some statements written on the front and backside of the t-shirt of that tall young man. So here, friends, the statements were: on front side it was, "No, I am not a basketball player," and backside, "Are you a jockey?" Then the author becomes excited to know the details of such slogans, and she approaches him and asks about the same. Then that young man tells him that the people always comment him on his height, and he used to get irritated and did not understand what and how to reply those people. Therefore, his mother suggested him to use these kinds of t-shirts having such unique quotations or statements so that there is no need to reply or respond to those people or such people in his day-to-day life. Furthermore, he says he has many such t-shirts, and one of favorite t-shirts of that young man was having a typical statement, "I am 6'3" and the weather up here is fine." So friends, it rightly shows how the idea given by his mother worked out, and he started neglecting the comments of the people. Here, friends, it rightly shows how to avoid arguments in a humorous, sporty and funny way. Then, friends, she gives us the example of the Internal Revenue Service of the United States of America. Friends, here IRS means just like the income tax department that we have in our country, that is India. Friends, as we all know, taxation is there in almost every country of the globe, and employees, businessmen, shopkeepers, industrialists, workers and all working people are supposed to pay tax to the government. So here, friends, many times people receive certain notices regarding the taxation and all, and they need to appear before the income tax officers at income tax department and expected to justify their typical stance with proper evidences and proofs. So here, friends, but one thing is true, mostly people do not like to pay tax and visit the income tax office and justify our stand and argue with the income tax officers, and all these things are there. Therefore, the Internal Revenue Service Department of the United States of America prepares some comic strips and cartoons saying it is not Internal Revenue Service, but it is Income Removal Service, and the secret is to stop thinking of it as your money. The reason behind putting such statements or cartoons is that people should take it casually and should not get angry with the officers, since it has no any alternate or other choice or way of waving off the taxes and all. So here Sam Horn gives us the example to make us familiar with such unavoidable commitments of our routine life, and if we consider such situations as an inevitable one, unavoidable one, then it will not give us pain and all. Then Sam Horn gives us the next important tip of avoiding avoiding the argument, and that is when people complain, don't explain. Friends, the author says that we should never explain anything when people complain, because if we explain and respond against their complaints, then their anger may increase and it leads us towards the argument or quarrel. And to prove this, again Sam Horn gives us some example. She gives us the example of a telephone operator. Here friends, there is one company and there is a telephone operator who receives a call from one of the customers like you and me, stating that he had requested for the list of articles before a week and still it has not been delivered to him. So he gets angry with that telephone operator, but the operator deals with that customer in a very soft manner, in a very polite manner. The operator apologizes to that customer for the delay and promises him to sort out the matter at the earliest. He also asks for the details again and promises him to fulfill his requirements at the earliest. Here friends, many times we also behave in the same way, mostly while interacting with the customer care executives of different cellular services or different products. We complain and get angry with them, and we should not we are not ready to understand their point or their stance. So here friends, besides, there are many occasions where we receive such experiences in our day-to-day life. Then the next example she gives us, and that is a receptionist at doctor's clinic. So here friends, the author shares her personal experience as an example with all of us. Once she visits one of the doctors and waits in the waiting room to meet the doctor. While waiting in the waiting room, she points out that there was one of the patient who had been waiting for the doctor for a long time in order to meet the doctor, and still his number doesn't come. So in irritation, he just goes to the receptionist and he gets angry. But here that receptionist deals with that patient in a very polite manner and convinces him. She accepts the irritation, inconvenience of that patient and tries to console that patient in a very excellent way, in a very positive manner. So here friends, after having heard all these words of the receptionist, that patient or the person becomes completely calmed down. Then the author talks about the skill of leaving the place gracefully or exit gracefully. Here friend, this is the third technique in a row, and here exit gracefully means leaving that particular place silently or wisely. Here friends, many times unwillingly we get involved in some arguments or people tempt us to be the part of argument. So in such situation, we need to be away silently, or better we tell them frankly that I don't want to be with you, or don't make me the part of this argument or debate, whatever it may be. Here also the author gives some examples, as the author gives us the example of an argument between a young man and his father-in-law. There is a married young man, and once he goes to his in-laws to have dinner. While having dinner at the dinner table, they start discussing about the construction of a highway which is going on around the in-laws' residence. The young man says that the ongoing construction of the road should be completed soon, because it gives him much pain in all respects and all. But his father-in-law gets angry with his son-in-law and calls him a selfish one, and he does not understand the importance of nature and such infrastructural development and all. He says it was an archaeological site and it strongly needed such development. Later on, friends, he leaves the dinner table and moves from that particular dinner table or that place. Friends, here the young man feels bad and thinks that he should not have expressed his thoughts in this way with his father-in-law. Instead of saying it directly, he should have put his words in other way also. Therefore, friends, many times we come across with such situation in which people have different opinions about the same thing. We cannot expect that all people should have the same opinion about the same thing. Here, friends, every perception or approach is different. Every individual's approach is different. And that's why such situation may come in our lives, day-to-day lives rather. So the perfect way of being away from such situation is to be agreed to disagreed in a polite manner. So here, friends, there is one Russian proverb: as a spoken word flies, you won't catch it. It means we must develop the habit of taking things and situations casually, lightly. If we stick up with the things and do not give such, you know, do not give importance to such unwanted things, or we must learn to leave the things time to time. After this, we have the next one, or the next example, and that is a perfect ideology of saying, that is, we both are right, or we both are absolutely right, we both are correct. Friend, this one is one of the tips given by Sam Horn, rather, where she says we are supposed to accept the opinion of next person whether we agree with him or not. We should try to convince him that we both are absolutely right and our opinions are correct. And here also, she again gives us one example of the discussion of husband and wife on the typical topic of, you know, teaching discipline to their teenager son or girl. After discussing for some time, they start arguing on the same issue and try to make each other realize how their methods are correct. In fact, friends, both of them have the same intention, but opinions and their methods are different, and after some time it or their discussion switches into quarreling. Here, friends, the motive or intention of this couple is the same, but still they fight to prove their point. In fact, instead of doing this, they could have settled down the issue by saying, we both are right, or we both are agree, or we should agree to each other. And this is what Sam Horn might be trying to convey through this example. Then, friends, Sam Horn talks about most important technique, which is gracefully bow out before you even bow in. Friends, here bow out means leaving the place, and bow in means participating in something. If, friends, there is a discussion or argument is going on a particular topic by our friends or colleagues, and there are two different opinions about the same thing, as we have just seen the example, and if we are asked to take one side, then what we are supposed to do in such situation where both the persons are good friends of us? So, friends, to prove this point, such situation, the author gives here one more example. And here, the author gives us the example of an election for the governor in the United States of America. So, there was an election going on for the position of governor in the USA, and the people of different two parties were blaming each other and trying to prove how they both are superior. There there were two people in the office of the author, that is Sam Horn's office, who were discussing who will be the next governor. One person was saying A will be the governor, and another person was saying no, B will be the governor. And one of them asked the author about her own opinion about this issue. The author immediately replies that, leave me out of this. I do not want to participate in this discussion. It means bow out before you even bow in. So, friends, basically all these are the techniques of avoiding the arguments that the author Sam Horn shares with us through this essay called How to Avoid an Argument. In fact, friends, eventually Sam Horn says that all these discussions or debates or arguments are no-win debates or no-win arguments. discussion. She rightly says that in such discussions or in such arguments or in such debates, no one will win. And if in case someone feels so that he has won, then the next person may feel that he has lost this argument. And he may have a negative shade of thoughts in his mind about the person who feels he has won the debate. Here, friends, the author Sam Horn rightly says that any kind of, you know, futile arguments are nothing but are waste of time, and nobody gains anything out of it except frustration, depression, jealousy, complexes, and breakup in relations. Here, Sam Horn says that there are different people in the society having the habit of argument or debate on different issues or different topics. And here, friends, finally, Sam Horn puts her most important and emotional statement. She shares it with us, and she says, if we save ourselves from such, you know, fruitless, unproductive and unnecessary arguments, then nobody loses anything and everybody will win everything. And therefore, we must avoid fruitless, unproductive and unnecessary arguments in our day-to-day lives. So friends, it is all about Sam Horn's popular prose, popular essay called How to Avoid an Argument. And friends, I hope you have liked this presentation, this video, and if you have really liked, then I request you to like it, share it among your friends, near and dear ones as well. Friends, if you are a new viewer to this channel and if you have still not subscribed to this channel, then I request you to subscribe the channel by just pressing the subscribe button and hitting the bell icon so that you may get the notifications of uploaded such academic videos on this particular channel called English Carnival in coming days. So friends, we'll meet soon again with a video of multiple choice questions based on this prose itself, that is How to Avoid an Argument. Till then, friends, just take care of yourself and be happy. Thank you very much.